Hey guys, welcome to Best Movies Recap. Today we are going to explain a 2007 thriller movie called Pirate of the Caribbean at World's End. Without any further delay, let's get started. The movie begins with the Lord Cutler Beckett, who is trying to increase his and the East India Trading Company's power in the Caribbean Sea by executing anyone, including women and children, suspected of or remotely associated with piracy. Beckett, who now possesses Davy Jones' heart, orders Jones to destroy all the pirates' ships. Condemned prisoners defiantly sing a song to summon the nine pirate lords comprising the Brethren Court to convene at the Shipwreck Cove and take action against Beckett. Meanwhile in Singapore, Captain Barbossa, with the help of Elizabeth, Tia Dalma, and the Black Pearl crewmen, going to rescue Jack. But to do this they need a map of the World's End, which Cao Feng, the pirate lord of the South China Sea, have it. This map will lead them to the gateway to Davy Jones' locker, where Jack is eternally imprisoned after being killed by the Kraken. Elizabeth and Barbossa bargain with Cao Feng for the map and a ship, but Cao Feng is furious, revealing that a thief had attempted to steal the map earlier in the day. The thief is being held in the bathhouse and is none other than William Turner. Cao Feng makes to kill him, tricking Elizabeth into giving away their connection to him by gasping in fright. After that, Barbossa reminds Cao Feng that the song has been sung, and all pirate lords are bound to convene at the Shipwreck Cove, and Jack must be there as well. That's why they are trying to rescue him. During the standoff, Cao Feng notices that one of the bathhouse residents has a fake tattoo, though Barbossa claims the man is not his. At that moment, the British Royal Navy, led by Mercer, make a surprise attack on Cao Feng's bathhouse. A battle ensued in the bathhouse, which would later lead into the streets of Singapore. Throughout the battle, there have been casualties on both sides, including many EITC soldiers and both of Cao Feng's bodyguards Park and Lian. At one point, Mercer overhears a conversation between Cao Feng and Will. Turner promises him a chance to meet with Lord Beckett and spare himself from the EITC's attention. Turner wants the Black Pearl to rescue his father from the Flying Dutchman. While Cao Feng wants to turn over to Beckett, presumably for immunity from Davy Jones' attacks on pirates. Cao Feng gives Will the charts and lends Barbossa both a ship and a crew led by Tai Huang. Then they depart Singapore for the World's End. Meanwhile, the Flying Dutchman is laying siege to a pirate fleet, utterly destroying its ships. In his office, Lord Beckett is musing on the significance of the Peace of Eight, wishing to know the location of the meeting place of the Brethren Court. While the Governor Weatherby Swan is being forced to sign execution orders, the crew of the Haipeng sails across a frozen ocean, and Tia Dalma explains to Pintel and Rigetti that Jack has been taken to a place not of death, but punishment. Turner tries in vain to decipher the cryptic instructions on the charts, while Barbossa, Gibbs, and Pintel fill in with information on the green flash, the signal of a soul returning to the world. Lord Beckett surveys the wrecks of the pirate fleet with consternation and muses that the Governor Swan is no longer of use to him. He orders the dead man's chest to be brought aboard the Flying Dutchman, berating Davy Jones for not leaving any survivors alive to question. Beckett reminds Jones that he is under his control, citing the death of the Kraken on his command. Jones is clearly not happy with the situation, but has no choice but to serve the East India Trading Company in its war against piracy. Meanwhile, Tia Dalma reminds Turner that there is a cost he must pay in the end to get what he wants most. The crew faces bigger problems when Barbossa leads them toward a massive waterfall at the entrance of the World's End. The crew attempts to slow the ship, which plunges over the edge and into darkness. In the maddening dimension of Davy Jones' locker, Jack Sparrow is suffering under hallucinations on board the Black Pearl. He sees multiple versions of himself crewing the ship, but cannot command any of them. He decides to take leave of his visions and jumps off the ship. He finds himself in a vast, seemingly endless white sand desert, where he encounters thousands upon thousands of crabs. Under sheer numbers, the crabs lift the Black Pearl and begin rolling it across the dunes, with Jack in pursuit. His former crew has meanwhile made it to the shore of the beach, having survived the fall into the locker at the cost of the Haipeng. The crabs retreat to Tia Dalma, just as the Black Pearl crests a nearby dune, with Captain Jack Sparrow standing high on its mainmast. Jack is reunited with his old shipmates. He is initially reluctant to rejoin a crew which includes the four people who once attempted to kill him, with one succeeding. As the Black Pearl crew seek an escape route, dead souls are seen floating underwater. Tia Dalma reveals that Davy Jones was appointed by Calypso, his lover, to ferry the dead to the next world. In return, Jones was allowed to step upon the land for one day every 10 years to be with his love, but when she failed to meet him, the scorned captain abandoned his duty and transformed into a monster. Elizabeth sees the soul of her father pass by in a boat, murdered by Cutler Beckett, after he became suspicious about Davy Jones' heart. Swan reveals that whoever stabs Jones' heart becomes the Flying Dutchman's immortal captain. With the water and the rum gone, the situation aboard the Black Pearl is becoming dire. Jack continues to experience hallucinations, during which he begins to form a plan to kill Davy Jones and Captain the Flying Dutchman himself, to ensure immortality. He receives inspiration and is able to decipher the charts, up is down. He lures the crew into rocking the ship, tipping it upside down in the water, just as the sun sets in the locker. The Black Pearl is transported back into the land of the living at sunrise, where the crew immediately pulls out their guns in a tense standoff. Barbossa informs Jack that the Brethren Court is gathering, though Sparrow is adamant he will not be attending. He assures Barbossa he will not be returning to the locker and attempts to shoot him, finding that his pistol has become waterlogged and will not fire. The rest of the crew have suffered the same setback and are forced to cooperate. Turner locates a freshwater spring on a nearby island, to which the crew sails to restock supplies. They find the carcass of the Kraken, Davy Jones' pet, who was forced to kill him on Beckett's orders, and here Jack realizes just how serious the threat to piracy's existence truly is. Further in, they are ambushed by Sao Feng, who reveals his secret agreement with Will. However, he betrays Will, having made another deal with Cutler Beckett to hand over the crew and keep the Black Pearl. The Endeavor arrives, and Sparrow is taken aboard, although he refuses to divulge to Beckett where the Brethren Court will convene. Instead, Jack manufactures a deal to lead Beckett to where the pirates will convene and lure them out for Beckett to destroy, in exchange for Beckett protecting him from Jones. When Sao Feng is double-crossed by Beckett, Sao Feng bargains with Barbossa to release the pearl in exchange for Elizabeth, who he believes is Calypso trapped in human form. Sao Feng attacks the Endeavor, which allowed Jack to escape. On board the Empress, Sao Feng has Elizabeth dressed in fine Chinese silks and calls her Calypso. Elizabeth plays along. At that moment, the ship comes under attack from the Flying Dutchman, and the captain's cabin is hit. Elizabeth recovers to find Sao Feng knocked against a wall, impaled on a piece of wood. He implores her to go to the shipwreck cove in his place, giving her his piece of eight, and names her his successor both as a pirate lord and captain of the Empress. The crew is rounded up on deck, where Elizabeth is reunited with Norrington. He claims to be unaware of Weatherby's death, and though he spares Elizabeth from Davy Jones, Elizabeth is unable to forgive him for choosing the side of the enemy. Meanwhile, Beckett and Lieutenant Grietzer are following a trail of bodies tied to barrels, evidently as a path to the shipwreck cove. Beckett considers it to be a gambit by a skilled opponent. It turns out that it is Will who is leaving the trail and is confronted by Jack, who mocks Will's decision to do as promised and leads Beckett to the shipwreck cove. He then reveals his intention to replace Jones as captain of the Flying Dutchman, allowing Will to avoid the choice between Elizabeth and Bootstrap. Jack considers binding himself to the Flying Dutchman to be a form of freedom, though he is not prepared to do the duty. He hands Will his compass, then sends him overboard, intending him to be picked up by the Endeavor. Going back to the Flying Dutchman, Elizabeth is surprised to find Norrington has re-evaluated his position and helps her to escape the ship with the crew. But before they manage to leave the ship, Bootstrap Bill is unable to realize that Norrington is helping Elizabeth stop them, which forced Norrington to hold him back but gets stabbed in the confrontation. Dying, James is confronted by Davy Jones, who seems set to offer him the choice of service aboard the ship. In response, James thrusts his sword into Jones' shoulder before dying. Jones keeps this sword for himself, and with the Admiral dead, believes command of the ship has returned to him. However, he enters his cabin only to find that Mercer has taken the key to the dead man's chest, becoming the Flying Dutchman's new commander. The Black Pearl arrives at the shore of the shipwreck island, where Barbossa confronts Tia Dalma. He names her Calypso and orders Pintel and Rigetti to lock her in the brig, ensuring she is unable to escape before Barbossa can free her. Meanwhile, Davy Jones is summoned aboard the HMS Endeavor, where Cutler Beckett is drinking tea with Will. Turner informs Jones of Jack's continued survival, though Beckett soon turns the conversation to the subject of Calypso. Jones is particularly vehement in lambasting his former love and is enraged to learn the Brethren intend to release her. Jones reveals that it was he who showed the first Brethren court how to bind her. Turner now strikes a bargain of his own. In return for the freedom of his father, Elizabeth, and himself, Turner will help to lead Beckett and Jones to the shipwreck cove with Jack's compass. And here Jones reveals that he wants to see Calypso dead. The fourth meeting of the Brethren Court is officially opened by Barbossa, who asks his fellow eight lords to present their pieces of eight symbols of their lordship, though in actuality are little more than pieces of junk. Rigetti hands over his wooden eye as Barbossa's piece, though Jack attempts to stall for time in order to avoid handing in his piece. Elizabeth Swan interrupts at that moment, proclaiming the death of Sao Feng and her position as his successor. The Brethren do not take well to this news and do not take Elizabeth's warning that the Flying Dutchman is approaching or her suggestion to fight seriously, believing that the shipwreck cove is an impregnable fortress. At this moment, Barbossa voices his plan to free Calypso to use her wrath against Lord Beckett. The court opposes the notion, and as the arguments turn into provocations, the meeting descends into a brawl. While the meeting continues, Davy Jones arrives on board the Black Pearl to confront Tia Dalma. He angrily asks her why she did not meet him on his one day ashore, and Dalma simply replies that it is her nature. She momentarily reverts Jones back to his human form, promising to give him her heart when she is freed. She also vows to turn against the Brethren Court and show them the full extent of her cruelty. The court stops fighting for a moment to listen to a rambling monologue by Jack, who agrees with Elizabeth, stating that the pirates must fight, if only to run away, pointing out the dangers of the other two plans. Calypso may not be too friendly towards the pirates, and they may kill each other off if they hole up in the shipwreck cove. However, Barbossa reminds the court that a declaration of war can only be passed by the Pirate King, and no one has held that title since the First Brethren. To settle the matter, Barbossa calls upon Captain Teague, Keeper of the Code, who confirms Barbossa's statement. Jack calls for a vote, upon which each pirate lord votes for him or herself until Jack seconds Elizabeth's vote, which makes her the Pirate King by popular vote. The Brethren are stunned and were surely set to have overruled the code had the infamous Teague not been present. With no other choice, Elizabeth accepts her new position and declares war at dawn. As the meeting comes to a close, Jack asks Teague about the nature of immortality. Teague states that the trick of it is not simply living forever, but living forever with yourself. Their brief reunion ends with Teague reuniting Jack with his mother, now reduced to a shrunken head carried on Teague's belt. As all the pirates get ready to fight, they see the horizon filled with Lord Beckett's massive fleet and became dumbstruck. Jack calls for a temporary parley, and he, along with Elizabeth and Barbossa, goes to a small sandbar to meet up with Beckett, Jones, and Will. Jack's deal with Beckett is revealed, and in a fit of anger, Barbossa slashes his sword at Jack, cutting off his piece of eight. Jack the monkey quickly grabs the piece. Elizabeth decides to trade Jack for Will. Jack is turned over to Jones, just as he had planned. As Barbossa, Elizabeth, and Will walk away, Jack the monkey secretly hands Jack's piece of eight to Barbossa. Seeing an easy way out of the battle, Barbossa then frees Tia Dalma Calypso and asks her to help them in the battle. As Barbossa releases her in a ritual, Turner discloses that it was Davy Jones, her lover, who betrayed her to the Brethren Court. Her fury unleashes a violent maelstrom, just as the Navy's massive fleet appears on the horizon. During the battle, Sparrow escapes the Flying Dutchman's brig and steals the dead man's chest. While Davy Jones kills Mercer and obtains the key to the chest, which Jack then steals from Jones during a duel. The Black Pearl and the Flying Dutchman face off near the center of the massive maelstrom. And at this moment Turner proposes to Elizabeth, then Captain Barbossa marries them in the midst of battle. Turner boards the Flying Dutchman to retrieve the chest, but he is mortally wounded by Davy Jones. As Bootstrap Bill attacks Jones, Sparrow, who wanted the heart for his own immortality, places his broken sword in Will's hand and helps him stab Jones' heart, killing Jones. Jack and Elizabeth escape the Flying Dutchman as the crew carves out the dead Will's heart and places it into the dead man's chest. The ship disappears into the whirlpool. Beckett, never intending to honor his agreement with Jack, moves to attack the Black Pearl. But suddenly the Dutchman resurfaces from the depths, with Will as the captain and the crewman now human. Turner and Sparrow aim the Flying Dutchman and the Black Pearl at the Endeavor, destroying it and killing Beckett. Although Will has been saved, and the Dutchman crew has regained their humanity, he is bound to sail the sea as the Dutchman's captain. Turner and Elizabeth have one day together where they consummate their marriage on an island. Then William gives Elizabeth the dead man's chest for safekeeping and departs at sunset. Shortly after, Barbossa again commandeers the Black Pearl, stranding Jack and Gibbs in Tortuga. Having anticipated Barbossa's deception, Sparrow has already removed the map's middle that leads to the Fountain of Youth.